At Atlassian, we've developed a three-step sprint planning process that has worked really well for our teams. The first step is backlog grooming meeting. The second step is the actual planning session. And the third step is creating your first few action items. Let's take a deeper dive into each of these steps and talk about the details. Hi, Megan Cook here, Group Prog Manager for Jira Software at Atlassian, the makers of Jira and other collaboration tools. So in our last episode, we talked about what sprint planning is and how it helps focus execution, minimize surprises, and guarantee overall higher quality code. Now let's take a closer look at how to do it. The first step, the backlog grooming meeting, is something that many developers will cringe at because it involves holding a meeting before the meeting. But good news, developers may be excused from it, and there's actually a purpose behind this approach: to save time during the actual sprint planning session and make that meeting more productive. You see, sprint planning involves two key tasks: grooming the backlog and deciding which work to complete in the upcoming sprint. At Atlassian, we found that the backlog grooming is best done beforehand in a separate meeting with the product owner and Scrum Master. We make this pre-meeting optional for the full development team. Regardless of whether they attend, you'll need at least 30 minutes to triage the issues you're most likely to take on in the next two sprints. Sometimes you'll find items that don't have enough detail to be executed or need more information from the product owner. And that's the beauty of grooming the backlog in advance. Those gaps can be filled in between meetings so that there aren't any blockers or time wasters during the actual sprint planning meeting. Check out the next video to learn all the ins and outs of a successful sprint planning meeting.